Our chief guest and speaker for the day is a very dear friend, Mr. Pradeep Lokhande. Can we all clap for him? You will be surprised how people reach out to him. People will just write on the postcard two things: Pradeep Lokhande and Pune. And the postcard reaches and you get a reply. So I think we are more known by what we do than how much we do it. His work for the rural part of this country has been appreciated with a lot of media houses, political houses, corporate houses, and he has gained that kind of reputation where no more does he need his address to be given to the local post office. He receives lakhs of letters every month where people write to him, and that has made him the most popular man with every post office probably in the country, not forgetting Pune. We always look out at foreign countries to look at for creating business opportunities. But friends, Mahatma Gandhiji said, India is a land of villages. We have got 6,38,000 villages in this country. But the villages which have a population of more than 2,000 are only 85,000 villages in this country. Mr. Pradeep Lokhande has reached out to 49,000 villages in 20 years. 49,000 villages, out of which he has personally traveled to 5,000 villages. He is an encyclopedia on the rural development of this country. No corporate, no company can penetrate the rural part of India without taking his guidance. He is a social entrepreneur who is connecting the corporates to the people and the population of the villages. And that is where the next growth of this country is going to be taking place. He has come up with a very fantastic concept of how you can connect with your villages. Basically, majority of the population living in this city is the guy who is living out of the country as an NRI, non-resident Indian. He has come up with a concept called NRV, non-resident villager. All of us are having some village somewhere, but we are sitting and living and working in some other city of the country. So he has come up with some very interesting concepts. A few days back, he has launched a very wonderful concept called Village Wiki. Village Wiki is the Wikipedia on these 49,000 villages. These 49,000 villages form 10 states of India. It was 9. After Telangana, it became 10. So he has covered 10 villages in 10 states in totality. By 2017, he aims to reach the entire 85,000 villages. He's a very powerful orator. You will be listening to him. I have requested him that we need to communicate in English. This is going to be a global audience and the content is going to reach all over the world. And he is going to share his words of wisdom, wise words of wisdom, which will be bridges for entrepreneurs like us to just move our attention to something that we are missing out on. Wealth in the villages. How we can improve their lifestyles and how we can still do entrepreneurship. Like I texted in our messages that when businessmen look at the top of the pyramid with a population, we are known as businessmen. But when we add value to the lives of the people at the bottom of the pyramid, we are known as social entrepreneurs. That is what this gentleman is. He is a social entrepreneur. Let us all welcome Pradeep Lokhande. Yes. So Pradeep, it's very interesting. You are in the concept of the rural development of India. What inspired you to get into this activity as a social entrepreneurship? It's not an NGO. It's a social enterprise where his objective is to make profits, at the same time add value to the lives of people who are not observed majorly by corporates in a very positive way. Because when we talk about a village, a lot of negative things come up in our minds. So what made you get into this activity?
No. First of all, I've taken a less travel path because I was not having education, a family background, a money. So what I was having is only enthusiasm and energy. So, and that's why I've taken a less travel path. And in 1993, there was a buzz, even today, go to rural India, there is a business.
Okay. And what has been your experience in the last two decades, in the last 20 years? Have you seen the shift of the corporates defocusing from the cities and more focusing towards the villages?
Not defocusing, but they are not defocusing from the cities, but definitely they are focusing the rural India. And you take any product of this country, any concept, any communication, whatever you have, everybody is concentrating on rural India, because you take any segment, there is a more market share than urban India.
So you create a bridge between the villages and the corporate India. When you talk about corporate India, then you're talking about the cities. So are you creating a bridge between these two?
Yes, because we understand the language of corporate and we understand the language of last man. So we are the bridge between both of them.
So what is the kind of network that you have built to make all this happen? What is the kind of network that is there at the disposal?
Yeah, we have created one concept called no need to go to all the villages of the country. Go to the villages having population about 2000 and where weekly bazaar takes place. If you are strong in these villages, you are ultimately strong in most of the villages of this country. And then we have started collecting data of these villages. You can say it's a kundali of that village, which will be used by a professional company as well as a social entrepreneurs.
Pradeep, you heard the profiles of majority of the people sitting in this hall. What do you feel can be done by these entrepreneurs as a business opportunity in the villages? What is that you feel is lacking in the villages, which is a underlying business opportunity that you can feel about?
No, don't take otherwise, but first, change the perception looking at rural India is the first step. Because what we think, whenever we think of rural India, we think that nobody is staying there, they don't have a money, they don't have a purchase power, will they buy my product, will they buy my concept, communication. First, we have to think that, you have to change our perception, and then there is a lot of opportunities. And that's what I've told you, you take any segment, there is a more market share, including financial sector. It is a more market share in rural India than urban India. So there is huge opportunity because communication is reaching to practically every Indian. Practically every Indian. There are five major changes which are happening in this country, and one of them is education. It is making a huge change. Means we are the largest elementary education system in the world. Out of 198 people doesn't know this. So this is the problem. And out of that 98%, 68% study in rural India. So there is an opportunity.
How do you change the mindset of the people in the village? You need to also change the mindset of the people in the urban cities. Only then the marriage can happen. So how do you currently do it with the villages?
No.
What is your mind change process that you are adapting
to? It is happening. It is not me. When any foreign agency says, we accept that. That is our another problem. Anyway, having said that, the biggest change which is happening because of education and communication, now everybody knows that, yes, I know there is a rural India. The changes are happening. For an example, if you take Maharashtra, more Mercedes sales in Kolhapur and not in Pune. More BMW sales in Aurangabad and not in Pune. So that change has already come in. So you have to catch that. But one thing is very clear. When you think of rural India, it is not an overnight story. There should be some consistency in it. And you should be very clear where I am going. For an example, as you have mentioned, we have 6,38,000 villages. Only 6,000 tehsils and block, and only 600 districts. Whatever happening in this country is happening in 600 districts. But above that, there are 6,000 tehsils, and above that, there are 6 lakh villages. And even by 2050, 50% people will stay in rural India.
Okay.
So there is a huge opportunity.
So the villages are not coming to the urban cities. The urban cities, people have to go there and create establishment and business opportunities is your feeler?
Yeah, because now you see what you require when you want to go to rural India is infrastructure, roads, communication. It is happening. Just 18 years back, there are around 2,38,000 villages where there was no all-season road. There now in India only, actually I put it this way, there are 5 lakh villages where there is a all-season road. So you can go there. Communication is reaching to 92% population of India. Satellite TV is reaching to 65% population of India. And the biggest revolution which is happening in this country is DTH. Every month, there is a 5 lakh installation of DTH in rural India. If DTH is happening in his house, means that household is connected to the world. You cannot stop him. He can see even bold and beautiful.
Fantastic. I'm sure Ratish and Vivek will be happy with this information. We're already seeing smiles because they want their music to reach every house of the country. So the connectivity is happening. And once you penetrate into these houses through technology, through communication, then business communication can happen, opportunities communication can happen, education communication can happen. How receptive are the villages for this to happen? How receptive are they?
No, now they are changing in a big way. Previously, he used to invest only in two things, that is gold and land. Today, he's investing in everything. He's investing in shampoo, he's investing in haversacks, he's buying a shoes, you name it, they are buying it. Ha! The biggest issue is branded product reaching there? Because who is overpowering branded product is a duplicate products. In this country, a duplicate product market is 15,000 crore rupees. Means he's inspired, he wants to buy. But most of the time, major companies are reaching there. But now, as I've told you earlier, that 2000 and above, you name any big company, they have already targeted that villages. They have a distribution system intact. They have a different distribution channel for urban India and a different distribution channel for rural India. So either you can ride on that, or the road, I mean that highway is already there, just you have to walk on that.
We had a mindset, Pradeep, wherein every guy from the city wanted to go to the United States, to UK and to Dubai. Okay, and every villager wanted to come to Pune or to Mumbai. So what shift do you see in that thought process? What shift do you see in that mindset?
No, it will change. You cannot change that mindset, but let me tell you how it is happening. Now, as we all look at US as our role model, they are looking at us. Means ultimately they are also looking at Western countries. It is happening that way. But what is happening is, now a lot of youth are going back to square one, and that square one is agriculture. And it is changing. In a big way, it is changing. Because I'll give you just one example, if you'll permit me. There is one exhibition which happens in Pune called Kisan Exhibition. In that exhibition, if you want to come, you have to pay 50 rupees. It is not a mela. You have to pay 50. You have to come on your own. And 130,000 youth visit that exhibition. It is purely agri exhibition. And out of that, 67% are educated, and out of that, 47% have visited Israel. So it's a huge change. It's a huge change which is happening in this country. What we have to, you actually should call one of them to this platform. Look, he is from a village, but he, one of the person around Pune, just 3 months back, bought one Rolls Royce. And he has posted that on Facebook and all that, WhatsApp and all that. But he has written one very nice sentence below that. I have bought this Rolls Royce not selling my land, but earning from my land.
Wow, I think it is a fantastic thing.
So that change has already started coming in a big way.
No, I can see what agriculture can do. In fact, a dear friend of mine sitting in this hall, Gregory D'Souza, has only 11 acres of land outside Palghar. But that land is worth seeing. That land produces so much that his factory people are eating out of that whatever is grown there. His house eats from whatever is grown there. My house eats from whatever is grown there. And our chairman's house eats from whatever is grown there. And it is still surplus. And he keeps on looking out for people whom we can give it furthermore. You get me? Very soon all these houses will be eating from that one farm. When you see that kind of wealth happening, we understand the power of farming. What do you think can enrich our villagers to become more productive per acre? Like when you see in Israel, Israel produces what Israel produces in 1 acre, India produces the same quantum in 30 acres of land.
I agree. But there is an issue. Please don't compare Israel with India. That is one thing. Because they have a different mindset, we have a different mindset. We are blessed. We are blessed, so we are lazy. Because we have 4 seasons. Yes, accept the fact. Because we have 4 seasons. We get rain, we get God, that sun, we get winter, we get everything. So this is an issue. Let me tell you, I'll put it this way. Now how it is changing, as I've told you, when you get money, it is the driving force, and the driving force is earning money and dignity. The biggest issue, and we should be blamed for that, urbanite, we should give a dignity to the farmer. Unless and until we will not give dignity to the farmer, that profession is not going to. For an example, now you all are educated. How many of you have studied the agriculture? Only 1, 2, 3, means what? Because there is no subject in our study as an agriculture. So how you will respect? When I ask my daughter or my, from where we get the milk, she says from the
Dudhwala.
Dudhwala. So sad. Lot of people doesn't know where come the mungfali. Upar aati hai ke niche. Nobody knows. It's a huge problem. So there is no dignity. And that is a problem. But as I've told you, the change is now he has realized previously the youth of rural India is to think of two things only. One, either he'll become a PI or he'll become a MLA. But today he has realized that is not possible. And the third option was, I'll try and get a job in government. But now he has realized because there is no job in government, everybody cannot be a PI, you cannot be an MLA unless and until you have tons of money. So he is going back to that square one, and that is agriculture. Now I'll give an example of a district called Usmanabad, which is comparatively drought a district of Maharashtra. Means in index of Maharashtra, it probably 23, 24 out of 36. But in that Usmanabad district, there are few farmers who are producing strawberries. And they are sending it to the London. That is the case studies we should blow up in a big way. Then the youth will come in this business. And we have to look farming as a business and not just it is my father's burden on me, so I'll do it.
Fantastic, fantastic. I think that says a lot. But what I feel is as entrepreneurs will always travel to where there is an opportunity to multiply their wealth.
Correct. Why not?
Can there be addition of the latest technology which can help multiply the productivity of agriculture, which can motivate not only the village farmers who are not educated most of the times, but if entrepreneurs go back to those villages and try to create, because in developed countries that we travel to, like Pradeep Lokhande has traveled to more than 23 countries in this world with the objective of how the villages over there, what are their mindsets and what are the technologies that they deploy to make agriculture more productive, right? So do you think if technology reaches to the common man in the village, it will change their livelihood, it will make it more remunerative and it will make them more professional agriculturalists?
Yes, it is going to happen. As I've told you, by 2017, practically every Indian will have an Android phone. And by 2020, the entire India will be educated. That doesn't mean he and she will write an essay or speak in English, but he and she will understand what is good and bad. That is a good day of this country. One. Second, as you have mentioned, unless and until we will not handhold them in technology, in doing something different, what is coming in rural India is contract farming, and they are using the technology in a big way. Let me tell you, I'll give you one example how now they are, it is changing in a big way. If you suppose you have a two bullocks, to maintain that bullocks, the yearly expenses are between 45,000 to 55,000 rupees. Now the tractor companies are selling, they are doing a pitch saying that, friend, because live animal is always a big issue. If you buy tractor, the EMI of that tractor is 70,000 rupees. So better you buy that tractor, and they are buying the tractor. The person who is having a 20 hours per tractor, they are selling an idea, please, don't use this tractor only for farming. Use this tractor for farming as well as infrastructural activity. Today in India, tractor has been used only 45% for agriculture and 55% for infrastructural activity. Isn't it a fantastic change in this country? It is. It is a fantastic change.
So I think once the villages in the rural economy are enriched by doing good agriculture and good revenue, then it becomes a better market.
It is.
Because any economy where the people have money in the pockets is an interesting aspect for the rest of the entrepreneurs to look at is as an opportunity. Yeah. Fashion accessories, clothes, housing.
You name it.
Yeah. So infrastructure-wise, what do you think are the opportunities available in the rural parts of India?
No, you take anything. First of all, as I've told you, infrastructure is very, very important. Now, what figure I know is, in next 10 years, even government is going to spend 50 lakh crore rupees on infrastructural activity in this country. Now, you take, we always discuss and we always say that no, this is only corruption in this. For an example, if you take Rajiv Gandhi Awas Yojana, what do you mean by you? You think that somebody comes, take money, you corrupt some people and go away. No, it is not like that, friend. Why cement industries are growing? Why steel industries are growing? Because of this type of activity. Because when you start building a house, you have to buy a cement, you buy a steel, there is a work for a mason. then he buys a color television, then he takes the DTH, then he wants that shampoo. It is a fantastic chain which is happening in this country. Believe me, friends, believe me. Probably, I am buying a bottle of shampoo of 300 rupees. My counterpart in a village buys a shampoo of 2 rupees, but the inspiration is same. There is no difference between inspiration. So it has already gone there. It is there. We have to capitalize. You name any business, I'll tell you there is an opportunity. You take education, opportunity. You take communication, opportunities. You take government activities, opportunities. We have to change that perception and looking at it. And there is a huge opportunities. As I told you, 15 crore students who study in primary in this country. So, and out of that 15 crore, 10 crore gets the midday meal. So if 10 crore students get the midday meal, it's a huge opportunity for a lot of business. Another example I'll give you. In India, every year we spend around 250 crore rupees on oral care advertisement. 250 crore rupees. But out of 100, 98 doesn't know scientifically how many minutes you have to clean your teeth. This is a problem of this country. So there is an opportunity. Can I get some business in it? So we have to look continuously this way. You name any business. Can I sell this? Can I sell? There is an opportunity for all the segment of which are available in this country.
So even housing should be an opportunity because people want to have a comfortable house.
Yes, yes.
How do you analyze of a particular village? For example, a village has a population of 5,000 people. Does your company get into the process of identifying their needs and then identifying entrepreneurs who can satisfy those needs? Or are you, it is a information on call, or can you also do that kind of mapping? The population of this village is 50,000. These are the opportunities available. Can you do that and bring entrepreneurs close to the opportunity?
Yeah, but let me tell you, you have to go by the phases. Now, you don't need to go to 5,000 pop starter village. First, think of, out of that 600 districts, are we there? Because the definition of rural differs from person to person, business to business. But the RBI definition, broad definition of rural India is more than 50% income from agriculture is a rural. Or where urban ends, rural starts. You take it the way you want. But as I've told you, no need to go to 5,000 and 2,000. First think of that 6,000 tehsils. There is a huge opportunity in these two tier towns of this country because they cater to 100 villages. It's a very happening place of that area. And there is a huge opportunity because there are government offices, there are small scale industries, and people who are comparatively rich in agriculture have a good or a bad house at Taluka place.
So your message is rather than satisfying the greed of the urbanites, satisfy the need of the villagers and you will create an opportunity.
You earn money out of that. You earn money. Give. Now every Indian, especially even rural India, want value for money. Take my word, friend. Value for money. He also wants value for money.
And you think that the gaps between the urban India and rural India is shrinking?
Hugely. We don't call it is a rural India. We don't call it is a rural India nowadays. We call it is a tomorrow's India. My definition of rural is now tomorrow's India. It is tomorrow's India.
Lovely. Now we'll have audience asking questions. Let us start asking questions related to your entrepreneurship. Yes. Yes, Mr. Deshpande.
You said the agricultural activities in the villages are growing and all the young and youth is also attracted.
Not all, but yes.
Most of them. So that there will be more and more agricultural product coming to the city because this, villages and cities, there is a relation always, all urban areas are depending on the villages always. And that is the way. And both of them are, they are in well-being only when both of them are enriched and both of them are growing, in a positive way. So if it is happening like that, can we expect that all the vegetables and all those agricultural products will be cheaper?
No, I'll not go by cheaper, but you'll get a quality product.
Okay.
Definitely you'll get a quality product.
More questions, please. Yes, Kunal.
Very good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My question is, as a service professional, how do professionals reach out to the rural and capitalize on this? I've understood.
Define your service.
Lawyer. Legal advice. Legal consultancy. I'm
legal
a lawyer.
Consultancy. Yeah. There is huge demand because they fight every day.
So, My question is more on the lines of...
No, don't take otherwise, huh?
More on the... I can cater to maybe 1 or 10 people at a time, but such a big, huge number...
No, you have to identify the place, you have to identify the area, you have to identify the region, and concentrate there, meet the appropriate people. There is a lot of opportunity, and even you can do a lot of social along with doing business. Because there are a lot of poor people whom you can give a free of cost, and there are a lot of rich people whom you can charge heavily.
So you can be the Robin Hood.
Yeah. No, not Robin Hood. But you can earn from them, and definitely, and there are a lot of people.
Subsidize,
I know one person
poor,
called...
Charge the rich.
Yeah, charge the rich. I know one person called Asim Sarode, who is in Pune. He is a fantastic example. Follow him.
I have interned under him. I'm from Pune.
Oh, great. So you have answered your question.
Yes, friends. Yes, Manak.
Hello, Pradeep ji.
Hi.
We just exchanged WhatsApp messages few days back.
Yeah.
And this is a pleasant surprise, Rajesh. Thank you. Before I ask my question, I also want to share something very exciting about Pradeep. I don't know if you remember, we were at Wellinker for a roundtable discussion. And the first time I've had somebody who has, you know, the magnanimity of asking a dean of a B school to say, ye MBA kya hota hai? In sitting in the B school. And before he could answer the obvious, he think Master of Business Administration, but ye master kaise bane? Business ko kabhi kiya nahi. And I must have spoken about this to so many people. So lovely. The question, Pradeep, is about distribution.
Yeah.
Now, we know that we perhaps produce one of the largest, we are one of the largest producers of milk. But what I do understand that Pepsi, Coke is available much more in the villages.
Correct.
Than
Correct.
Milk. Can you give some insights on how can, you know, not just the MNCs, but like, this is a fantastic question, distribution of legal services.
Yes.
What are your thoughts and observations around distribution? What can we do differently to make sure that a lot more reaches there?
No, I'll give you, we have a fantastic example of Amul. It's not a multinational. It's a fantastic example. It's basically a federation. And equity to whom? To a female of a village. You know that what a system they have? You cannot take a milk to that center. Who takes the milk to that center is only a female. And that milk is being judged there and there, and they will be paid. And you will give the entire milk what you have in your... And you will buy milk from them. So that belief is really fantastic. There are few cooperatives in Maharashtra and few in Gujarat and in Uttar Pradesh doing fantastically. But basically it's a perishable product. And the best answer to milk product is not only a milk, but a byproduct of milk is very important. And it will happen. Because now the consumption is growing in a big way.
He is talking about a distribution channel. How can that infrastructure be set up?
Now you can, we have another concept in Pune called Sabji. So you get a fresh Sabji between 8 and 12 in the morning. And they charge more than anybody else. So it is happening, but it will take time. It is not an overnight story. And basically consumer has to believe. One day you get onion for 10 rupees and the next day you get for 20 rupees. You start doing shouting, I don't understand. When you go to any 5-star hotel to eat, we spend 10,000 rupees on that day, but just that 10 rupees gives you a crying, I don't understand most of the time. Another example I'll give you. You buy a shoes in air-conditioned room, air-conditioned shop, and you buy a vegetable on the road. How we look at it? It's a huge problem in this country. Because we are not giving, again coming back to that dignity issue, unless and until he will not get money. Actually, what we have to do in this country is a reverse calculation. Reverse calculation is this. In this year, you will get onion for 75 rupees a kg. Not 65, not 1,005. And then ask him to work because your production cost is 25 rupees. Now we are going to give you 75 rupees throughout the year. That is the only answer. That will probably drive him to give you the best quality product, which has happened in one case in India is of soya bean. All thanks to ITC's e-Chopal. Now, if he produces a good soya bean, he gets a good money. And there only. So it is happening.
The problem there is also about disintermediation.
Where?
The channel. It's about the disintermediation of the channel.
Now,
any problem, right?
Now you take Madhya Pradesh. vast and scattered. If you take Maharashtra, comparatively populated. If you take Uttar Pradesh, these are the issues. We have a lot of issues, cultural issues. We have a language issues. We have a habit issues. But I'm not looking at that now. I'm looking at every consumerism has reached to practically every Indian. How best we can capitalize on that?
Any more questions? In countries like US, Walmart has sorted out the distribution issue. They take you from the farm and deploy it into the shop. So there needs to be somebody who can replicate the Walmart, which I feel Reliance is doing it in a very, very big way. Reliance Fresh is with the same objective, reaching out and sorting out the distribution challenge. Yes. We'll start from here backwards.
No, she has a question.
Okay. Yeah, Swati.
So my question is So my question is how your study can support villagers, farmers as well as urban people, like if we can distribute who will grow what? And what is the weather condition, and accordingly, if we can request farmers to grow that product so that there will not be any excess product, so that tomato will be at the rate of 3 or 30 or 300. So can we channelize that?
It's a big question, but I'll answer you. This is a policy decision. I'll tell you. Now, first of all, you cannot teach a farmer. Because he says that I am doing this for last 5,000 years, please don't teach me. That is one. And another issue is, they have been cheated for last 65 years, and we all are responsible for that. We only blame, we take all 10 fingers to the politician and we get rid of it. No. You take seed, there is a problem. You take fertilizer, there is a problem. You name it. He's been cheated royally for last year. So he's not believing you. The only hope now is the young, educated youth of this country. Now he is realizing, now he is using that technology. He is thinking, he is going to that different exhibitions. He's going to Israel. He's understanding it, he will do it. But if you go there and he'll say, do this because I am educated. Share me rao. Dhanyavaad. Kharido mera. You buy my product. Don't tell me more than that, please.
Swati is also an excellent farmer, and I'll tell you some hobby of hers which will scare the whole audience. One of her hobbies is to catch poisonous snakes live.
Oh!
Didn't I say you will be scared? That is one. Secondly, if you see her driving a Scorpio, even Anand Mahindra will feel shy. Scorpio. So that's Swati. She does lovely farming. She has got a lovely farm in Alibag, where she runs a resort as well as she does very creative farming. Yes.
Yeah, there's something called as priority sector lending. Priority sector lending. Most of the nationalized banks and the other banks also in India. So what is the thing missing in that entire chain? Like, you know, because that is also a medium where the people can be financed there. So is it that the people are not knowledgeable with the same? I'm talking about the people in villages and all. Again, farmers, because priority sector is more on the agriculture and the rural development and all. So why aren't they open to that? Or if they are, so what is the thing missing in that entire chain?
No, they are not missing. Previously, what used to happen? Now, because of technology, a lot of things are coming in front. A lot of data is available. And now government has made compulsory. Now, if you take a financial sector, and especially insurance, unless and until you will not sell 20% in rural India, and specific they give the villages, you have to sell only in that villages. Similarly, they have given an, I think RBI person will, somebody is from RBI. I worked with Thorat. She was a deputy governor of Usha Thorat. So that time what they have tried to do is first we have to do a financial literacy in rural India. That is a big problem. No, a lot of people doesn't know. Because previously, as I've told you, invest only in gold and land. But all the government undertaking, even banks like ICICI and HDFC are making inroads in rural India in a big way.
Even Yes Bank.
Yes Bank.
Even Yes Bank.
Even
Rana Kapoor.
And what farmer says, you know, I don't mind paying 2% more than the other banks if you are giving me a service. Means it is a consumerism. Again, So it is happening, but it will take time. There are a lot of issues. As I told you, 71% people were not having female in Rural India a bank account. But just
now that
3 months
has
back,
begun.
Yeah,
yes.
it has gone down.
Yes.
So these were the issues. But now it is changing with the technology in a big way. And government is taking stand on that.
Yeah, Rohit.
Yeah, hi Pradeep.
Hi.
In fact, our relationship goes long way. We were speaker at one place and you know, I was to leave urgently after my speech. But he was so powerful that I was glued to the last moment.
But did you become a farmer?
Oh. Okay, now my question to you is, you know, you've been running around all over. And Maharashtra has a rich heritage of cooperative movement. And over the year, it has been, you know, badly abused, eroded, all that. So is it time to revive that movement and what we can do to, you know, revive that movement?
No, cooperative is definitely dying. Everybody knows this. There are a lot of issues. We'll not discuss that. But what is coming in is a federation. And most of the company, now the very fancy name is FDI. What do you mean by FDI? Foreign direct investment. But now our term, now it is farmers direct investment. So it is happening in this country. Farmers comes together. Now it is not a cooperative. But they give an equity to him. As in milk, they will come together. And he will get the equity of, if suppose we are collecting 100 liters or we have 100 acre land and you have a 5 acre, you will get 5% out of that. So the bargaining power is more. You can do the marketing. You can afford to have a professionals in your organization because previously it is only managed by the politicians. But now even in these federations and cooperatives and contract farming, there are professionals and they are managing it fantastically.
Fantastic.
Any scope of recreating the Amul magic again in Maharashtra?
No, it happens once in a lifetime. Now you go to Mahananda Dairy, which supplies milk to you people. In a
Kolhapur.
Yeah, Kolhapur. Doing fantastic. But the fight is always there.
About the cooperative sector, my very dear friend, Inspector LG Shinde has a very good statement. He used to always say, वैयक्तिक फायद्यासाठी सामाजिक गुन्हा म्हणजे कोऑपरेटिव्ह सोसायटी
असं नको
वैयक्तिक फायद्यासाठी सामाजिक गुन्हा म्हणजे कोऑपरेटिव्ह सोसायटी बिकॉज ऑल द कोऑपरेटिव्ह सेक्टर्स वर ऑलवेज कंट्रोल बाय द पॉलिटिशियन्स सो एव्हरी कोऑपरेटिव्ह सेक्टर वॉज क्रिएटेड टू सक आउट फंड्स फ्रॉम द गव्हर्नमेंट नेव्हर रीच द फार्मर्स अँड दे मेड मनी आउट ऑफ इट
नो एक इसमें मैं बात करना चाहूंगा बट नो यू कैनॉट से दैट वे आई गिव एन एग्जांपल यार ये बहुत ही डेंजरस
आई डिडंट से दैट जेंटलमैन
नो बट आई विल ट्राई एंड नो लिसन वेरी केयरफुली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट परसेप्शन अगेन वन शुगर फैक्ट्री गिव्स एन एम्पावरमेंट टू मोर दैन 25,000 फैमिलीज डायरेक्टली एंड इनडायरेक्टली So it's a fantastic thing. Accept the fact. How many big organizations are giving support to 25,000 families in this country? So we have to accept that. We have to accept. Now, have you heard about a place called Akluz in Maharashtra? It's in Solapur district, Drought district. I will not take the name. Sahib, now na ghenar, kaaji karu naka. No, their turnover is 1,000 crore rupees. There are not 10 MBAs and 20 PhDs. They manage it. 1,000 crore per year. And they are in agriculture. They are in sugar. They are in liquor. They are in wine. They are in milk. You name it. And yes, they have a jet. Yes.
And they have better roads than Bombay.
And their Gram Akluj. Panchayat is the richest Gram Panchayat of Asia. So don't go by that few bad things of this country. There are a lot of good things which are happening in this country.
Abhijit.
Further to what was spoken before, how do you see the influence of brokers? We are talking of essential commodities from rural villages coming to the cities being done away with. Example, for just a few days back on this conversation, inspiring conversations, texting messages we had discussed, like a sabzi which costs, say example, 4-5 kilos, which the farmer sells and ends up being sold here at 70 rupees, that disparity. This has been tried for last 3 decades.
True.
And despite people's objections or the knowledge about it being known to be the general masses, we've not been able to handle that issue. It's not just here, it's throughout India. Why and how do you see it being done?
Yeah, there was issue, yes, because most of the farmers was in the hands of moneylenders. So total hand, you cannot do anything. But now it is changing. That is one. Now, most of the places, there are 52 commodities in this country. Government decides the price of that. That is minimum support price. So everybody knows now in this country, what is the price of onion, what is the price of sugarcane, what is the price of cotton, what is the price of different beans across the country. And you get that information at every APMC, Agri Produce Market Committee, and they flash it. And there is one company which is called Thomson Reuters. Reuters, everybody, you all must be aware about Reuters. They broadcast the price of commodity of that day. So farmer knows that this is the money which has been for my produce, whatever produce he has. So it is changing. It will take time. Previously, it was in the hands of moneylenders. Now it is changing. That's why you get a lot of things. You think that it is a costly, but it is not. We have to think that way.
Yes, you do. Abhijit Deshmukh has just retired from the, yeah, Mr. LG Shinde will ask the question. Abhijit Deshmukh has just retired from the Navy at a very young age. He was holding a very high position with the Navy and he was doing supply chain management as well as purchasing of a couple of 1,000 crores. So he knows the entire gamut of how India procurement functions. Yes, Shinde sir.
Hello. I'm not Shinde. He mentioned regarding my statement about the cooperative movement. I'm from the same place you called upon.
That 1,000 crore village.
I'm from the Akluj.
Are you Bapre?
Yeah, why to Akluj? Actually, cooperative movement is the best movement in practical, but the implementation, which way it is being done, because it is in the hands of a politicians.
Handful of politicians.
So, because of that, this movement has been, you can say, bad named.
Yeah, I agree. Now, but you go to just from Akluj, you go to Malinagar. They are doing fantastic.
Yeah.
You know that, no?
I studied in the Malinagar.
Oh. Too many coincidences. what part of that 1,000 crores that belong
I'll
to you?
I'll give one example of Malinagar. Malinagar was a barren land. One person from Saswad, next to Pune, there is a place called Saswad.
Yes.
His name is Haribau Balwant Girme. He has migrated from that place to Malinagar. And think, 70 years back, he has tied up with Alfa Laval of Germany. Yeah. 70 years back. And they have equity in his factory in Malinagar. Unbelievable. Don't think that they are, and it is not me talking about it. Go to Google.
There were six.
God can't answer every question, so he created Google.
There were six farmers in Malinagar who started that factory in 1936.
Correct.
And those six farmers were only running the factory of a thousand tons per day's crushing.
Correct.
For 8 months.
In 1936.
Yes.
Wow.
There are a lot of good stories in this Maharashtra,
yes,
especially across.
Siddhu will come with that sequence. And Mr. Sikwer also has to ask a question. Yes, Siddhu.
Good evening, sir.
Hi.
You are knowing everything about rural market. We have been speaking how urban people can go to villages and do business. My question to you is, what are the innovative products of rural which can be bought to urban and can be sold at premium?
Now, the issue is, as I've told you, when you buy any product, say for an example, pickle. You think that you will get a good pickle. You will buy once. But unless and until you will not make a brand out of it, they are going to make money, nor you are going to buy a second time. That is the biggest problem of this country. Biggest problem of this country. Because out of, I don't know, I will not go into that key, because you feel bad about them, you buy once. But that is not a story. That is not a story. There are a lot of people are doing this type of activity. Huge across the country. If you go even Chhattisgarh, they produce different type of articles in Chhattisgarh. But the marketing is a big issue. But who is responsible? Not the marketer, but most of the time the manufacturer. Because our mentality is an issue. We should tell them that, friend, somebody is investing money not to help you, but to buy that product. So he wants value for money. Now you go to any part of the world and a big store, you'll find one grape called Maha grape, which comes from Pune. They have created a history. Now it's a federation. It's a fantastic case study. What they have done, they have created a different groups across Maharashtra, across India, of grape farmers. And then they give the knowledge to these farmers because they have a bargaining power. And who is the head of that is a farmer, a grape grower, farmer. And they are doing fantastically. Only once few farmers have done nonsense, 3 years they were banned across the world. So this is our, but it is changing now. It is changing. When you get money from foreign currency, you travel there. Now in Akluj, they are producing grapes. India's best wine, it is not now in Nasik, but it's in Akluj because they export 90%. 90%.
Excellent, excellent. Next question. So branding is one opportunity is in
any consumer across the world.
Yes.
Why you pay more?
We just saw an example of branding today, Pradeep. Sandeep has created a beautiful audiovisual presentation where for the product of eyeballs, they have engaged Kareena Kapoor and she came and branded, and the fortunes of that company has changed. So even if that pickle is branded by Kareena Kapoor, probably the sales will be much better.
Good example.
The farmer will be happy not only to sell it on higher margins, but happy that even Kareena is having it.
Yeah.
This kind of thought changes needs to happen. I've seen so many people who have gone where there is a lot of growth of tomatoes happening.
Yeah.
They have gone and installed ketchup factories there. A finished product gives you more profits than the raw product.
And most of the time what you think is, whenever we say this, you are a capitalist. That is not a thing. Because unless and until you are not answerable and accountable, it will die.
Last two questions. Yeah, Mr. Sikwera.
I am born agriculturalist.
Oh, great.
Of course. Now I'm not in that.
You're farming shares now.
But what my experience is, in this country, of course, maybe due to the various steps which you are telling, things may move. Otherwise, the farmers are not, very few farmers are making money. Those who own acres together, land and all that. Otherwise, poor farmers, they are not making money. Particularly because of that wages have gone up due to Narega scheme and all that.
True.
And on the contrary, laborers are not available. Particularly, I am from Konkan area. There are no people available to climb coconut tree or to arecanut tree.
True.
People are not available. So people are giving up because it is not manageable. But anyway, But at the same time, I am totally with you that as far as the trading opportunities are there are many opportunities.
Yes. There are a lot of opportunities.
Next question, last. Yeah, Sandeep.
We'll take 3-4 questions.
Okay.
Hello.
Pradeep says three more questions. So, Hemal, you're in line.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying as many questions
as. Yeah, Sandeep. Please. Yeah. No. Pradeep, carry on.
Okay.
Sandeep.
Hi, Pradeep. Hi, Rajesh. My question is very simple, and I would like to have your point of view. Is since we all be talking about the educated lot going back to agriculture land and trying to develop it. But at the same time, if you really look at it, there is a lot of second homes happening there. A lot of farmers are actually selling the lands, and there are parts and parts have been sold for second homes. So which is actually making farmer lazy, and farmer is thinking that that's a life. Because if you really look at it, I'm sure you are a master in that, so you know that. That 4 months when the rain comes where the farmer works, and after that farmer doesn't work. And for him, just 4,500 bucks is good enough for him. And what does pothi uska chawal mila uska pura saal ka khana ho gaya. The fact is that he's now selling that land, and the second homes which we urbanites, we are going there and we are just using that as a second home for the parties or for the weekends, but we are not doing anything with that land. Where do you think that there should be, like, you know, where you go to Kerala, there are coffee estates are sold with the land, where the people who cannot afford, the farmers who cannot afford, the people who can afford can go there and actually can create something out of the land than just going and using it as a second home. And because of that, all these young youth, which are supposed to be future farmers, are working there as the caretakers and the cooks. So do you see, I would like to have your views on that.
Yeah, well, let me tell you, yes, the labor is a big issue because of Narega, food security, a lot of things. There is an issue. But I see an opportunity in it, because now farmer is thinking, I will do the automation. So he'll do the automation, it will take time, but the day will come, he'll start earning a good amount of money. That is the thing. Now, yes, you take the villages, we call them as a fringe villages, where there is a land cost is gone up like anything. And they think that someday somebody will come to me and he'll buy my land. But it applies to only big metros. And if you go to, say, Hingoli, do you know Hingoli?
Yes. It's close to Gujarat.
No. Anyway.
Marathwada, sorry. Hingoli, Marathwada.
Hingoli.
I got confused with another village.
Borodi?
No, not Borodi. I'll tell you the name.
Okay. So, khatam ho gaya? Ye keh rahe kuch baat nahi karne ka. So, friend, don't think that, yes, now if you take Kokan, practically somebody or the other of a family is in Mumbai. So it is as good as you are there. No need to tell them anything. He knows everything. So don't think that what you are thinking, he wants to sell the land, there, that. No. But if you go to, say, 100, 150 kilometers away from big metros, it's a different story altogether. Different story altogether. We think of Kolkata, Mumbai, Chennai, Delhi is not India. India, as I've told you, 6,38,000 villages. And it's a huge number. The biggest issue is vast and scattered. But as I've told you, the only thing which will change this India is technology. And technology is coming in a big way. Now, when you buy a lathe, do you know the cost of that potato, the 1 kg cost of that potato? 800 rupees a kg. You buy it. You know, you don't. So, my message to the farmer and to everybody is, whatever you have now, you have to brand it and band it. Band baja. India mein wahi bikta hai, across the world wahi bikta hai. Think always. Because ingredient sells 50%, wrapper sells 50%. The wrapper is a problem in this country.
That is his business also. Yes. Make a very attractive wrapper.
Yes. And then you can sell it. Because the young generation want that attraction. The availability. And it is happening. Packaging industry is changing this country. Previously, it was difficult. There is a disadvantage to it also. If you'll buy a Parle Ji, there are 132 look like a Parle Ji in this country. 57 of Fair and Lovely. So these are the issues. But there is an advantage, as I've told you. Packaging. Now, government cannot do anything with the packaging industry because they are promoting SMEs. So we are going through that turmoil. We are actually 21 year old when all this has started in 1993. So it will take time. We should have a patience. Yes, one generation has to crush to get benefit to the next generation.
Homeopathic treatment.
Yes.
Last two questions. One is Hemal and one is Ratish. Ore, so many wants to ask. Quick questions and short answers. Come on. Ratish.
Sorry,
short
answer.
Hemal. Hello. Can I ask?
Please.
Yes, Ratish, yes. Please.
Yeah, please.
I just want to know, you know, as he introduced, we are connected with music. So what kind of consumption of music is there with rural
I'll
India?
I'll answer immediately. Yeah. Because we have less time. We have done one study on value-added services.
Okay.
They spend minimum 35 rupees to 150 rupees on value-added services. Means some part of that is a music.
On mobiles.
So it is possible to connect the music interest of all villagers.
Across.
Because music is a universal
language. They
celebrate
31st. They celebrate everything.
Every function.
In a big amount.
Yes, Hemal. Come, you. Quick.
So how do you view MNCs? Are they foreigners who will take our money and go back? Or like Walmart coming in and everybody coming in? Are we not again going back to them? And my second question is, how can we stop farmer suicides? Is there a way out?
It is happening. There is altogether a difference too. Means we can discuss 3 hours on that.
If you start paying them their prices, they will stop suiciding.
Yes, that is one. And second, now I never bothered about who will take what. If you have a fantastic product than the Walmart, you have a different fantastic system than a Walmart, apply it. Otherwise, let them do it. Because now, as I've told you, because of education now, he understands where I'm buying, why I'm buying, what is the cost. And there is a competition. Now, it is not what Walmart is going to do. They cannot sell all of a sudden onion from 10 rupees to 100 rupees. They cannot do that. Now you say, you go to any Reliance Mart and you see that there is a always say that ki today this will be, the cost of that will be less than the market price. So the it is advantage to the consumer. We take it that way. And so benefit will go to the farmer because he has to pay him in a big way.
Kokadadeb, mic the other. And Sangeeta is the last question.
Pradeep ji, have you visited villages in Vidarbha?
Yes. Tumhi Vidarbha tle ka?
Yeah.
Haan.
I am Buldana. Buldana.
Ek thoda 2 minute bolu ka nako. Thoda kadal na Marathi.
Let me ask the question.
बोला बोला हरकत नाही
हां तुम्हाला मी तुमच्या प्रश्नाचा कसं इंटरेस्ट वेगळा उत्तर देतो तुम्ही प्रश्न विचारा तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना सांगतो कसं कल्चरल डिफरन्स आहे बघा मी विदर्भातल्या यवतमाळ जिल्ह्यातल्या एका छोट्या गावात एकदा गेलो होतो 4 वाजलेले होते आणि तेवढ्यात ढग भरून आले आणि तो शेतकरी मला म्हणायला लागला की तुम्ही निघा आता लवकर चला इथं चालू लागा आता पाणी येणार आहे म्हटलं पाणी येणार आणि मी जायचं काय संबंध भाऊ तर तो म्हटलं नाही तुम्हाला जावं लागेल पाणी आलं तर तुम्हाला आता जाता येणार नाही तर विदर्भामध्ये पाणी येणार आहे म्हणजे पाऊस येणार आहे
यस
आणि आपल्या पुण्यात आणि मुंबईमध्ये पाणी येणार आहे म्हणजे नळाला पाणी
येणार
आहे आपल्या भारतात इतकी डायव्हर्सिटी आहे ह्यूज डायव्हर्सिटी त्यामुळे मी गेलोय कळालं ना तुम्हाला
आता येस 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 डेफिनेटली सो माय क्वेश्चन इज देर इज अ बिग थ्रेट ऑफ स्प्युरियस ॲग्रिकल्चर प्रॉडक्ट इन विदर्भा इजंट इट
येस
सो व्हॉट्स द सोल्युशन हाऊ कॅन वी कट धिस मॅनेज
नाही बघा तुम्ही पूर्ती हॅव यू सीन द पूर्ती कन्सेप्ट ऑफ गडकरी
Yeah.
Don't go by that what has happened in electronic media and all that. Forget that. You just go. One day he has called me. We want to buy 100 tractors to our farmers. How much? 100 tractors. So it is happening. It will take time. Again and again I'm telling you.
No. I am talking about the spurious agriculture product like seeds.
It is not only in Vidarbha, sir. I have told you initially.
Yeah.
Ki he's been cheated royally for. But.
That's what you mentioned in the seminar.
Yes.
The
only tool is education and nothing else. The only tool to this problem, it is in fertilizer, it is in seed, it is in packaging, everywhere there is a duplication. But I feel pity not only to, but he has also, he should understand that I have been cheated this year, I have to look into, but he has been, as I have told you, he has been by money lenders. Across Vidarbha.
Because the farmers don't have a voice about this. Huh?
They have a voice, but they are using that their voice for different purposes. That is a problem. Yep. That is a purpose.
And their voice is not heard.
Now, how Vidarbha can come together to have a separate state? They have taken a referendum and more than 80% say that ki we want a separate Vidarbha. They should come. Now, you have 2-3 issues which I see. You have a fantastic land in Vidarbha.
Yeah.
Second, you have that Jhudpi jungle. You know that, no?
Yeah.
There is another concept in Vidarbha is a Jhudpi jungle. And the third thing is, no, I'll not fall down. And the third, and very important is, comparatively good water.
Very good.
A flat land.
Very.
But the biggest issue is comparatively lazy.
Yeah.
You know that.
Yeah, yeah.
You go in summer in Vidarbha, between 11 and 5, nobody will do anything. Sorry.
Very true, very true.
Jopun jar rahila, ta nahi na. Kasa honar. So these are the issues which will change slowly.
Yeah.
And it is changing. Yeah.
Sangeeta, the last question for the evening.
Namaskar, sir. Namaskar. I'm also from Pune. My question is, which are the top 5 needs of rural India you have identified, which we can brand and promote?
No, need you are talking about.
Need, yes. Need.
Yes.
Top need, 5 needs of the
village. Needs of the rural India. I'll tell you.
Right.
Education, communication, power, roads, sanitation.
So I think everybody has their attention.
Yeah, everybody. All are there. All the 5 people are there in this hall. 5th one is sanitation. Sanitation. Yes, yes. So I think friends, we are all done. We can take it offline. And we have got time limits for the activity. Okay, chalo, 2 last questions, come on. One there, one you, quick.
लोखंडे साहेब तुमचं सर्वप्रथम
एन्काउंटर नाही ना करणार आहे तर देतो उत्तर.
सर्वप्रथम मराठीमध्ये बोलतोय मी. सर्वप्रथम तुमचं अभिनंदन.
धन्यवाद.
बऱ्याच वेळा लोकसत्ता महाराष्ट्र टाईम्समध्ये बरंच तुमच्याबद्दल वाचलेलं आहे. इथं ज्यावेळेस राजेश सरांनी तुमचं नाव घेतलं त्यावेळेस बरंच काही क्लिक होऊन गेलं आणि आठवलं. थोडं वेगळ्या ह्यानी बोलतोय. तुम्ही चालतं बोलतं कॉम्प्युटर ग्रामीण भागातल्या स्टडीचं असं म्हटलं तर हरकत नाही. एवढा तुमचा स्टडी आहे राजेश सरांनी पण सांगितलं. बरंच तुमचा अनालिसिस मी ऐकलेला आहे. मी मुद्दाम सांगतो, मी स्वतः एम एस सी ॲग्री आहे. माझा मित्र इथं बसलेला हाही एम एस सी ॲग्री आहे. बॅकग्राऊंड सांगतो आता जास्त इथं डिस्कस. इथं व्यावसायिक लोक आहेत जे दुसऱ्या पारड्यामध्ये आहेत आणि ह्या पारड्यातले आम्ही आहोत आणि तुम्ही मध्ये आहात.
आम्ही मध्ये इकडे
तर
साहेब एवढं तुम्ही बायकोसमोर कधी बोलत नाही.
माझ्या दुखऱ्या इश्यूला बोलू नका, आपण वेगळं बोलतो. मुद्द्याचं बोला. होतंय काय, बेसिकली जो इश्यू वेळोवेळी चर्चा केली जाते की बाजारभावाची किंमत ही व्यावसायिक ठरवतो आणि ॲग्रिकल्चर आउटपुटची जी किंमत आहे तो शेतकऱ्याला ठरवायचा अधिकारच नाही आहे आणि सर्व इश्यू तिथंच निर्माण होत आहेत. तुम्ही जे आता बरंच तुमच्या डिस्कशनमधनं सांगितलं की ग्रामीण भागामध्ये एवढं मोठं मार्केट आहे हे बरोबर आहे. ज्या ठिकाणी दवाखाना नाही त्या ठिकाणी ह्याचं मोबाईलचं दुकान थाटलेलं आहे.
अगदी
100% एवढं मोठं मार्केट झालेलं आहे. आणि तुम्ही मगाशी सांगितलं म्युझिशियनला, त्यांना ते 31 डिसेंबर बी साजरा करतात, ईद बी साजरा करतात आणि ख्रिसमस बी साजरा करतात.
हां, आणि जेवायला नसलं तरी
करतात. तर डिमांडिंग एकदम मोठं आहे. त्यांनी जर रिबॉकचा शूज नाही घातला तरी तो कुठल्या तरी दुसऱ्या कंपनीचा डुप्लिकेटचा घालतोच.
300 रुपयाचा
घेतो.
इन्स्पिरेशन सेमच आहे.
हां, मार्केट अतिशय मोठं आहे. पण हे सगळं करत असताना ॲग्रिकल्चरबद्दल जेव्हा ही मंडळी चर्चा करते आहे तर त्याला भाव ठरवायचा अधिकार काय, किंवा तेच मिल्क या ठिकाणी येतं आणि प्रोसेसिंग होऊन त्याच 1 लिटर दुधाचा प्रोडक्ट जो मध्ये मार्जिन राहत आहे तिकडे डायव्हर्ट होण्यासाठी लोकांना काय सजेशन आहे?
हो, मला मी एकदा म्हणजे मला हात नोटी मोठा का असे मराठी सांगू हिंदी इंग्लिशमध्ये कसं
नाही नाही बट इंग्लिश बिकॉज लेट एव्हरीबडी विल अंडरस्टँड. एव्हरीबडी
लँग्वेज तुम्हाला कळेलच साहेब.
द होल वर्ल्ड इज वॉचिंग.
लेट मी टेल यू वी हॅव ॲक्च्युली आय हॅव अन्सर्ड दॅट क्वेश्चन इनिशियली की वी हॅ देर आर 52 मेजर कमॉडिटीज इन दिस कंट्री विच इज बीन नीडेड बाय प्रॅक्टिकली एव्हरी ह्युमन बीइंग. सो इफ यू डिसाईड द प्राईज फर्स्ट हँड, से द कॉस्ट ऑफ बीन्स, वी आर द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्युसर ऑफ द बीन्स इन द वर्ल्ड बट प्रोडक्टिव्हिटी वाईज वी आर नंबर 52. So both are responsible. One, farmer is also responsible. If the Myanmar is doing fantastic than Indian farmers, so there is some problem in it. There is some problem. We have to accept that. And laziness and this and that. One. Another problem of a farmer is unless and until he becomes a 65 year, he will not give a baton to his son. By that time his son is 45 year old. So he'll not do much. This is another problem of this country. And third, a crying business always and all the time because they have two gods. One is a sun god and second is a government god. If there is more water, we want money. If there is no water, we want money. So these are the issues we have to face and it will go with. Now most of the agriculture graduates go into the government services. I think it is good or bad, you have to decide. Because if they come into the agriculture, probably they will do it in more. I am not saying don't go into the, yeah, but you go across Maharashtra, all the deputy collectors, all the COs are agriculture graduates. It's a big mafia. So only answer to this is, we typical middle class of this country, the day they will decide, probably you will not like this sentence, ki now I want to do a good to my farmer, then it will be changed because they are 25% of that 120 crore. So it's a big number. It's around 40 crore can spend huge amount of money on the, and these are the necessities. It can be milk, it can be grains. Now you pay 60% to 600% more to organic food. And if you just get 20% more the cost for a regular produce, you start crying. So this is an issue in this country. But how it will go when Gregory Peck start buying that organic farming, people have started or not. Are kiti varsha jagnar organic khaun sudha? 110 varsha nahi na jagnar. 80 varsha marnaras is tu tari sudha. Ghane rada kha ka changla kha. So we have to believe in farming. We have to believe in farming. And that unless, is farming a business in this country? Probably no. You go to any farmer of Vidarbha, porgi milti kao? तो म्हणतो एका छोट्या ऑर्गनायझेशनमधल्या प्यूनबरोबर पोरीचं लग्न करील पण फार्मरबरोबर करणार नाही. इट्स अ बॅड सिच्युएशन ऑफ दिस कंट्री. बट आय एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दॅट, आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द ब्रायटर साईड विच आर हॅपनिंग इन रुरल इंडिया. आय कॅन टेल यू 30 hours ऑन दॅट ऑल्सो, बट नो पॉईंट डिस्कसिंग दॅट फ्रँकली स्पीकिंग. बट ब्रायटर साईड इज दॅट 40% ऑफ अर्बन टिपिकल मिडल क्लास. So there is more than 30% typical middle class of rural India, and probably he has a more money than urban India because his expenses are less than you and me. Because you commit from one point to another point, you have to invest a lot of money. You have to go to pub, have to have good perfume and this and that and that. But he is now investing a lot of money on buying a lot of products. So you take any big brand of the world are looking at rural India. And the biggest, there are actually 6 revolutions which has happened in this country. We talk about only green revolution of 60s, but there is green revolution, then white revolution is milk, which has happened in 17 and 18. Then color revolution is a color television in 82. Then sachet revolution is 90. Then there are the huge revolution, yellow revolution with that Sam Petrando's Dabda across the country. Then across the country. You just put in 1 rupee and you reach to the this corner to that corner. Then next to that, next revolution is internet, and current revolution is a mobile. So by 2020, practically every Indian will speak with you with the help of 4G. It is going to happen, friend. It is going to happen. Nobody can stop that, because that is not from the road. It comes from like this. So there is no obstacle. And there will be only one language in this world, and that language will be computer language. Take my word.
Lovely. I think that was very inspiring. That comes to the conclusion. That comes to the conclusion of the evening. And
I want to say two more sentences.
Okay, in English.
In English. Listen, this sentence is very important. Irrespective of caste and religion, the entire youth of this country is inspired. इन्स्पायर्ड. जिथे जात नाही गाळ बैलगाडी तिथे जातो मारवाडी गेले दिवस आता. अँड द सेकंड, गर्ल्स आर स्टडिंग अँड दे आर गोइंग टू चेंज दिस कंट्री. बिकॉज नाव आय विल गिव वन एक्झाम्पल. यू गो अक्रॉस द कंट्री, यू ट्रॅव्हल एनिवेअर अँड यू विल फाइंड वन वुमन हू कट दॅट स्टोन. यू मस्ट हॅव सीन अक्रॉस. There is one kid sitting there, one kid, irrespective of rain or whatever it is, she does that. Go and ask her what you want to do in life. And out of 100 will tell you that I want to teach my daughter and son. Isn't it a fantastic change in this country? It
that
is,
friend. Next revolution.
Next revolution, which has already happened. So India is changing in a big way. There are a lot of issues. Should we discuss 120 crore issues or should we discuss what is happening good in this country? 120 crore population, 120 issue. In spite of that, think these are the good things which are happening in this country. Thank you very much.
And before we conclude the evening, we have to introduce two more people. Vivek Mendonca, the man who gave vision. the man who gave vision to the country. He is Lawrence and Mayo.
Yes.
Because Mahatma Gandhi, Indira Gandhi, Sonia Gandhi, all the current Gandhis, past Gandhis, all wear glares from. Now he is changing the political party because their vision has gone wrong. And Vivek Mendonca coincidentally happens to be Suhani's husband. And that is Shugra. Hi. That is where I get my salary from. That is Shugra Athaide. She coincidentally happens to be my wife. And she handles the St. Angelo's Computers education activity. So friends, that was very inspiring and very wonderful. I would like to request Mr. Gregory D'Souza and Shugra to come up and give a moment to Mr. Pradeep Lokhande. Lokhand sir ka awaz hai ki na hai? Na ugasas nahi hai Lokhande. The entrepreneur farmer. Please, come Shugra.
Thanks.
शुक्रा उड़े मैं हूँ ना Thanks a lot, friends, and we come to the conclusion of the evening, and let us all interact with him offline. And one more new thing happening today, which Pradeep Lokhande is going to inaugurate. We are launching the mobile app today for inspiring conversations. And Pradeep will do the honors. Where is Nishant? Nishant is here? Milin, Nishant is here? Okay. Ek second, tana photo tari khichun dya. For publicity. Okay. Yes, so this is how the Inspiring Conversations is. This is live currently on the Android Play Store, Google Play Store. And soon you will be seeing a lot of changes in that. We will create our own community, and there are thousands and lakhs of followers for Inspiring Conversations. We will bring it into our app very, very soon. This is a very basic app. As the days pass by, we are going to improve it. And like the culture after every event, sir, we would like to request you. We want to beat the number of photographs you clicked on your marriage date. So I will request my friends to come up on the stage one by one and let us click pictures with our chief guest. Thank you, friends. Thank you.